Hello and welcome to HD Calcs. I'm Rick, and today we're going to have a look at how we can use the memory function to store and recall variables on the Texas Instruments BA2 Plus calculator. To do that, we'll be using the STO key that looks like this, located here, the RCL key that looks like this, located here, the second function key that looks like this, located here, and the zero key with the second function of memory that looks like this, located down here. Now this calculator has 10 memory slots, one for each number key. So 0 to 9 are each a memory slot. We can store a variable in them by placing it on the screen. So there's 10, then pressing the STO key, and then choosing a key we want to store it in. So let's put this 10 into memory slot 0. You won't see any indication on the screen other than a little decimal that appears after the number there, letting you know it's been stored. You can also store the result of calculations. So if, for example, we go 1 divided by 2 equals, we get 0.5, and we can store that into memory slot number 1. Again, by pressing STO 1, there we go. Now, if you want to recall a number from a memory slot, you press RCL and then choose the slot you want to use. So let's recall that 10 from the first slot by pressing 0. And there we go. We see the 10 has appeared on our screen. We can also add and subtract numbers from memory slots. So let's add that 0.5 from memory slot 1. We do that by pressing plus recall 1. There's that 0.5 equals. And you can see we have 10.5 now. And we can store that into memory slot 2. All right. You can view what you have stored in memory by pressing the second 0 key, which is the memory key. And that'll bring you to this screen. Here we see M0, which is memory slot 0, has a 10 in it. If we scroll down, we see memory slot 1 has 0.5. Scroll down again, memory slot 2 has 10.5. Remember, that's where we stored that. And if we keep scrolling, we see that all our other memory slots have 0 or nothing stored in them. And we keep going and we come back to 0 and 10. We can clear these memory slots by pressing second CE or clear work, which will clean the memory slots but not get rid of anything else. So we press that. Now we see M0 is equal to 0. And if we keep scrolling through, we'll see all our memories are 0. And we're ready to store new numbers in there. You can also overwrite memory slots without clearing all of them by just storing over that single memory slot. So remember, if we had, let's say, 10 stored in 0 and our 0.5 stored in 1. There we go, 10 and 0.5. And we only wanted to overwrite our memory slot 0. You can just enter a new number in there, let's say 2, store 0. And if we check our memory again, we see memory slot 0 is 2, but we still have our 0.5 in memory slot 1. Storing and recalling values is really handy on this calculator if you want to do a long or complicated calculation, because it lets you store complicated numbers without having to type them in over and over. An example of this would be, say, using Pythagoras to solve for a right angle triangle. So, for example, if we wanted to solve this right angle triangle, and we know that a squared plus b squared equals c squared, and can be rewritten as the square root of a squared plus b squared equals c, and we want to solve for our c unknown side, what we can do is store our two known sides as a and b. So let's store 4 as our a. 4 store into 0, let's say, and 3 into slot number 1 as our b. So 3 store 1. There we go. And we can View our memory to confirm it's in there. Yep, 4 and 3. Looks good. Now we can just enter this in as a formula. So if we go a squared, which we can get by recalling 0, which is our 4, squared, plus b squared, which was, recall our number 1, there we go, squared, adding them together, and then square rooting the whole thing, we see we get a result of 5, which is our c, and solves our triangle for us. All right, I hope this helps, and good luck on those tests out there, everybody.